Joining us now, one of the legal counsels and spokesperson of former Senator Laila De Lima, Attorney Dino De Leon. Attorney De Leon, welcome to the program. Thanks for joining us today. Really appreciate it.
That's for Attorney Nadal, our viewers.
All right, less than 24 hours since the release of Senator De Lima. How's the senator doing?
Well, of course, she's ecstatic. The first thing that she did was to go to Our Lady of Manawag against our advice. The story was we were pleading her to make sure that she's safe, precisely because she already experienced a harrowing near-death assassination. I always call it assassination because it is what it is in Camp Crame. So we were begging her to make sure that she prioritized her safety, but she cried and she said, we don't understand how important it is for her to go to Our Lady of Manawag. So she went there to pray, to thank Our Lady and, of course, the Lord, that finally freedom is given to her.
Is this going to be sort of the new normal now, that you're going to try and keep her safe, try to sort of restrict her movements in a way for her safety, but then he's going to plead, and then you're going to give in?
Well, it's we have very limited means to keep her safe, which is why we would want to urge the Marcos government to make sure that Senator Laila De Lima will remain safe as well. No? It might be the new normal, but you know, Senator Laila De Lima, we've always pleaded with her. A lot of her previous staff pleaded with her to no longer continue the investigation on the war on drugs, to make sure that she politically conserve herself first. But that's not the character of Senator Laila De Lima, which is why I continue to volunteer as her lawyer, because she fights for what is right. She does what she thinks is right. You know? So that's the relationship of, you know, lawyers and their clients and principals and their staff. You try to convince each other, but ultimately it's going to be the decision of the principal or your client as to how to move forward.
Well, what was the most difficult part about winning this freedom, although not yet absolute, for Senator Laila De Lima? We followed this very closely. You and I have had the opportunity to talk throughout the course of the three cases. But what was the most difficult part in winning her freedom?
Well, it's the struggle. It's the struggle in between. No? 6 years was just too long. And it wasn't just her being incarcerated. She was politically attacked every step of the way. Her reputation was destroyed by an organized machinery of the state. No? This is the greatest frame-up. I always call it the frame-up. And it's not just the greatest frame-up. It's subsidized by taxpayers' money. It's in the airwaves. It's in the halls of Congress. It's the Department of Justice was used. The inmates were used. A lot of political organs and institutions of the state were used. So the most difficult part, I think, even for Senator Laila De Lima, when I was just about to start as a lawyer, was when she cried. She said, and she asked a question, I distinctly remember, why is it that I am alone? It felt like she was alone at that particular point in time. And the struggle in between, you know, when I was campaigning for her, Carmina, if you would remember, mm-hmm. I was the one who was campaigning for her during the elections. A lot of people seem allergic towards us because that Duterte was still in power during that time. Sometimes, even if I talked to local government officials during the campaign, it felt like they were so cold or they were trying to distance themselves from us. No? So the most difficult part is the fact that it was a very lonely battle, but at least right now, Senator Laila De Lima was able to show that indeed, if one carries on insofar as her convictions are concerned, then ultimately there's a possibility that one will triumph.
Now, Attorney De Leon, you would expect that she and you, because as you said, you sort of were her alter ego during the campaign seasons, you would expect that from the those opposed to your ideals and really what you considered as the enemies, right? Not wanting to touch you with a 10-foot pole. But are you also saying that there were once people whom you thought were allies, but all of a sudden didn't want to go near you?
Oh, a lot. And in fact, you know, and this can be seen in the sentiments in social media, you know. There were a lot of people who initially voted for Senator Dayet de Lima, but eventually got they were made to believe that she was a nasty human being, so to speak, right? So and right now, what's good about it though is a lot of them have been messaging. There were people who messaged, and I would like to think that they're sincere. They would say that they apologize to Senator Dayet de Lima because they were made to believe that she's a bad person, and they in fact allowed their platforms to be used in this greatest lie in Philippine history. And a lot of people are now apologizing. I don't know if that is a positive development in that sense here, but as Senator Laila de Lima would always say, there's vindication anyway. A lot of us human beings commit mistakes along the way, but what is important is that, you know, we ask for forgiveness and we try to move forward from there.
You know, a while ago you mentioned about, in so many words, the weaponization of the law, the entire system being pit against your client, former Senator Laila de Lima. And so when you hear former Duterte spokesperson Harry Roque say that the former president was not behind all of what happened to the senator, that he did not have anything to do with it, what do you say to that?
You know, I used to watch Attorney Harry Roque when I was still a law student, and I admired him a lot when he was still defending human rights and the rule of law. And I just have to say that it's unfortunate that he is now peddling lies. And these are lies that he knows for a fact are, these are lies, and he knows that for a fact. Why does he know that for a fact? Because he has constantly heard no less than Rodrigo Duterte say that Laila de Lima, that he's angry at Laila de Lima. In fact, and I quote, he says, "Laila de Lima, you're finished. Laila de Lima, you will rot in jail." And then all of a sudden, here comes Harry Roque, who used to be, you know, defender of human rights, who will sanitize the actions of the president, and he will claim that he has nothing to do with, the cases filed against Laila de Lima. That's just peddling lies, and it's unfortunate that he's sticking with that particular narrative. But I don't think that Attorney Harry Roque would be able to fool the Filipino people. He has to preserve the credibility that he has left, if any, and he has to come clean, and he has to admit that in fact Rodrigo Duterte authored this greatest frame-up in Philippine history.
Well, in an interview that I had with him yesterday, he not only said that the former president did not have anything to do with everything that happened to the former senator, he also said that it was actually another politician, no longer in power now. But this politician, he said, was a victim of the witch hunt. And he was actually the one behind this, or this politician was the one behind this. Is this the first time you're hearing this?
Well, I've heard it before. I've seen Harry Roque, and we were interviewed in another forum together, and he has been peddling these lies. No, two things. The first one is, why is it that he's not naming names? That's first. Second, if he is indeed really categorical about all the things that he is saying, he never offered himself as witness because, you know, he has opinions on the demeanor, let's say, for example, of the witnesses who recanted, but he never offered himself as a witness. In fact, Harry Roque's credibility right now when it comes to this particular topic is stained because he participated in the persecution of Laila de Lima. So I don't think that we should be giving him any airwaves anymore because we shouldn't be allowing the airwaves to be propagated by lies as spitted out by the likes of Attorney Harry Roque.
There's another thing that he said in that interview yesterday, Attorney De Leon. It's that, number one, he's an officer of the court and he respects the court's decision. But in the next breath, he did say that it is unfortunate that the court has now believed the false testimony offered. Your thoughts?
You know, if he's referring to the bail petition and the motion, the resolution, it appears that he hasn't read it yet because the recanting witnesses were not mentioned there. What was mentioned were specifically the witnesses that already testified who did not recant, right? So that's first. But secondly, If he is indeed an officer of the court, right, and he respects his oath, he also has to he has to also be candid and say that that jurisprudence allows recantations as well, especially if they point out to the direction of the truth. No? Mm. So, well, if these people, especially, let's say, for example, Rafael Ragos, was cross-examined by the prosecution for hours and hours and hours, and he was able to withstand all the questions because he was telling the truth. And the truth is, he was used, he was coerced, he was threatened, his life was at risk and that of his family, and which is why he was forced to testify against Leonel de Lima. And it wasn't just Rafael Ragos. There are around six witnesses already. You know? So the pattern is apparent, and that is that the state used its machinery to threaten witnesses against Leonel de Lima to manufacture evidence. And we have to hold people into account, including the Duterte administration and the officials who orchestrated this greatest frame-up.
Mm. Attorney De Leon, you were always certain from the get-go that the prayer for bail was going to be granted, but then the twist and turn started to happen. You were always confident that the evidence against the former senator was not strong at all. But when the twist and the turn started to happen, what was going through your head?
I was just a three-year-old lawyer or four-year-old lawyer when I started to join this case. Now I'm on my 10th year in practice. No, there are things that only happen in this case that I don't see in law books. No, at the onset we were very hopeful that the rule of law will prevail, but we had to carry on despite all of the disappointments. As we've said, there were twists and turns, there were hot and cold treatments, but we had a very strong principle, we had a very strong client who has always believed that this is the way to go, that we have to fight through the justice system. She voluntarily surrendered herself to the authorities despite the fact that she's innocent. She has never missed a single hearing. She has always been compliant in all the court orders and court processes. And despite the fact that us lawyers, and we're just also human beings, we're disappointed from time to time, we had a very good anchor, and that anchor was our client, Senator Violet.
There was another comment yesterday, or a statement that was released by another former spokesperson turned presidential chief legal counsel, talking about attorney Sal Panelo. He said that if, however, the former senator is finally exonerated, she nevertheless deserves her years of detention for the wrongdoing she has committed against former president Gloria Macapagal Arroyo when she was Secretary of Justice, defied the order of the Supreme Court by stopping the former senator or the former president from leaving the country for medical treatment. What do you say to that, Attorney De Leon?
I for all the lawyers listening out there and the younger ones, no. You shouldn't copy what this person is saying. This is not a good example of somebody who's upholding the oath as a lawyer. He has no authority to say, because it's not the judiciary, that just because he thinks a person did something, automatically he deserves to rot in jail for 6-7 years. That is not how justice works. And if they all believe that Leonel de Lima must be held into account, then they should have filed charges accordingly. And she should be convicted in a court of law. And as for so long as she's not convicted in any court of law, then she does not deserve to be in jail. And, no one deserves to rot in jail despite the fact that she may have committed mistakes in the past. All the things that they're saying about what happened to Gloria Macapagal Arroyo, that is legally debatable, and if they had qualms, they had remedies against Leonel de Lima. But of course, she does not deserve to go to jail just because she was just doing what she did was right. Because if that's gonna be the case, and this is the reason why this is political persecution, if they think that Leonel de Lima deserves to go to jail just because she was fulfilling her duties as she thinks it must be done, how it should be done, then that is political persecution. So that is actually an admission from no less than the former presidential spokesperson that they are engaged in political persecution just because these people were fulfilling their mandate as, you know, cabinet secretaries or senators.
Watching the press conference last night, the former senator was very measured in her statements. But reading between the lines, you know that she knows that there will be a time of reckoning. So when you talk about the game plan for exacting justice for what happened to the former senator, what is that game plan, Attorney De Leon?
Well, Senator Lai De Lima said that we are discussing it at this point in time. What does that mean? It means that we are just discussing the details of how to initiate it, when to initiate it, as to whether it should be initiated. She also mentioned that hindi naman pwedeng walang mananagot, lalong-lalo na sa mga bumabuhay ng justice system natin. No? So it's gonna be, the details are, we were discussing it and we've been discussing it for quite a while now. We're readying based on the instructions of Senator Laya De Lima. But definitely, Senator Laya De Lima recognized that the reason why she was jailed is because the battle is bigger than herself. It's because of her political convictions. It's because of her belief on the rule of law, on the justice system, on democracy. And in order to uphold that, then those people who authored this frame-up should be held into account. Those people who are engaged in political persecution should be held into account. So you are right to say that, of course, she knows for a fact that eventually there will be a day of reckoning, the details of which we will have to finalize as her lawyers and as her legal team.
When will you begin to exact justice for what happened to her?
As soon as Senator Laya De Lima gives the go signal, because, you know, all of these things are documented anyway. In fact, this is one of the most well-reported political persecution in Philippine history. It is documented anyway, and there will be available forums, not just domestic, but even internationally, to hold these people into account.
And finally, Attorney De Leon, I was talking to Attorney Shel Diokno yesterday. Because the fight to exact justice for what happened can and cannot or can stand without her, right? But is it imperative, as legal counsel, is it imperative that she takes the lead here? Because others can pick up the fight, and that's what Attorney Shel was also saying yesterday. It's a foregone conclusion that there must be a continuing fight to exact justice. But it doesn't have to come only from the former senator. But I'm asking you now, is it imperative that she leads this?
Well, because she experienced the travesty firsthand, so it would be desirable for her to lead it. But Attorney Shel Diokno is right, and in fact, a group of lawyers were the ones who filed the case against the former judge in criminal case 167. You know, we've also led the we've also filed cases against, let's say, for example, the former justice secretary. So as lawyers, we can also be complainants, and it's just gonna be a matter of strategy. But as to our willingness to fight for what is right, to hold them into account, of course, that is no longer a question. We would be willing to file the necessary charges, even as lawyers and in our personal capacities.
Attorney Dino De Leon there, former Senator Laila De Lima spokesperson and also one of her legal counsels. Thanks a lot for joining us this afternoon. Really appreciate it. Take care.
Hey, thank you, Fernie.